drunk again, Harry. We have a case here. It might be. I can't say it on the phone, but you know what I mean. We need you here, Harry. I'm sending someone to pick you up. You have 5 minutes.
A drunk detective is Norway's only hope to catch bad guys. Really? Hi, Fiction Fandom. I'm Tim, and today I'm gonna review the Mr. Nesbo Harry Hole series. It's a 12-book crime fiction series. I kept reading the rest in digital format as ebooks, so here's an illustration of all the 12. Let's get on to the review, shall we? I'm not a big crime fiction fan, to be honest, but when my dad recommends a fiction piece, he usually knows what he's talking about. He had me growing on classics like Jules Verne, for example. So what I did is enter a bookstore, I know, very unlike 2019, almost 2020. I bought the first book my eyes lay on, which was The Midnight Sun by Mr. Nesbo. And it's a short book, it's a 1214 pages total. I started reading it for the Norwegian places and the Norwegian names, which is very unlike all the Hollywood series we have nowadays, which was very intriguing. But I stayed for the plot and the character build. So I highly recommend it if you want to check the Mr. Nesbo vibe to start with this book. It's a very short one. The most important thing to ask ourselves before picking up a crime fiction novel or series is how good is the puzzle? Because if the puzzle isn't interesting enough, not just for us readers, but also for the detective in the book responsible for solving the crime, then it just won't be interesting and the book will fall flat. In that aspect, the series really succeeds. I didn't guess even once who the murderer was in each and every book, and that comes from a guy who watches enough series and movies to usually predict what's about to come, so he did a really good job there. Character build is good, especially Harry Hall. The alcoholic thing is a bit overused in fiction, but it's done in a really good way in the first books at least. After a few books, it starts feeling a bit mundane. The real problem is other characters, which are not Harry Hall. You have characters who have 5-10 pages dedicated for them to describe them, but they don't provide anything to the plot and they just end up dying. They provide the body, which Harry Hall finds out later. I felt cheated when reading these scenes, and it makes the book's pacing a bit slow sometimes, although it does pick up the pace usually after the mid-end part. Other characters, which can be considered as main characters, are not round enough. What I mean by that is that sometimes the plot has to advance without Harry Hall. You won't always be in the spotlight. You have other characters, you have other plot lines. And the other characters, which can be considered as main characters, are not good enough to carry the plot. They're not round enough. They don't have an arc of themselves. And after reading the series for a long time, I ended up coming back for the character itself, just for Harry Hall. It felt a bit empty when he wasn't there because he shines so bright, we don't see the other characters. Foreshadowing is also a thing Mr. Nesbo does well. Foreshadowing means laying clues for us readers to guess what's about to come without telling us directly. The way he does it is laying clues, which is related to other parallel plots, which we're not aware of at the time. It makes us feel as if we know who the killer is, but in fact, we have no idea. He's done it in such a good way that, as I told you before, 12 books after, I have no idea who the killer really is. Versatility is also a strong suit of these books. When you have a few books in a series or a few seasons in a TV series, they end up being molded into this certain pattern, which you end up noticing and it becomes predictable and you're bored because you know what's gonna happen, so you're not entertained anymore. Some of these books follow a similar pattern, but most of them have a completely different pattern. It's as if Mr. Nesbo treated some of his books as experiments, and it was done in a really good way. Most of the time I opened up a book and expected to find the same pattern, and it was something completely else. It usually feels really, really fresh when you open up the next book in the series. Something that really surprised me about this series is continuity. A character appearing in book 1 ends up being shown in book 5, for example. I'm not talking about the main characters, I'm talking about side characters which are not really important to the plot usually. It's sort of like a fan service for us dedicated writers, so that's really awesome, sort of like an Easter egg. The other thing about continuity of these books is that there are side plotlines which are not resolved, which end up becoming main plotlines in other books. It doesn't happen in all the books, but it makes the plotline feel like a long line. If you're reading the Harry Hole series, I recommend you to read from start to finish. It really adds up to the experience. Another thing that really surprised me are the action scenes. Although there are not a lot of them, Mr. Nesbo wrote some of the best action scenes I've ever read. Some of them are really gruesome and teeth-clenching. The last thing this series does really well is world-building. I'm not just talking about Norway, since Mr. Nesbo is Norwegian, he knows this place around Norway. I'm also talking about the other places that are featured in the books. Some of them feel a bit flat, and that's okay. He's not native to them. The thing that really feels well is the cultures and history he's talking about. I learned a couple of new things I didn't know about before I read the books, so that's really awesome, picking up a book to be entertained and learn new things along the way. To sum everything up, is this book for you? Do you love crime fiction? Do you love great character build, foreshadowing, world building, or a really good puzzle? If you answered yes to one of these questions, pick up the first book, you won't be disappointed. Trust me. If you're still on the fence about reading the Harry Hole series, I highly recommend The Midnight Sun. It doesn't have a puzzle like the Harry Hole series, but it does deliver the Mr. Nesbo vibe. Go ahead and pick it up, it's just 200-ish pages, you won't get invested in the entire series. For your convenience, all the books I talked about are listed down below, so check it out. Put a like if you like this video, subscribe for more content, and don't forget to click the notification bell to get notified of newly released videos. I've been Tim, and you have a great day, my fictional friends.